fundamental of sterilization. See, what do you mean by sterilization? Sterilization is a process in which you make any object or any item or any product free from microorganisms. That is the fundamental definition of sterilization. And first thing is, you need to understand one thing, that a complete 100% sterilization cannot be practically demonstrated. What does it mean? So there is an indices to depict that how well the sterilization has been done to a product or a sample, but a 100% sterilization of any finished product cannot be ascertained without degradation of that product. What does it mean? If you have any product, if you want to practically demonstrate that it is completely sterile, so that means it should be completely degraded by some or other methods. This is a fundamental definition of sterilization. So if you further, if you see the various terminology in sterilization, the first one is sterilization. So sterilization is the process of removal of microorganism and its spores. So once you remove the spores, further the spread of microorganisms is inhibited. So sterilization is a process where microorganisms as well as its spores are being removed. So this is a fundamental definition you need to understand. Disinfection. Disinfection is a process of killing microorganisms but not its spores. Matlab, when you clean your surfaces, that is any laboratory surfaces or any your home, by any sort of disinfectant, say Lysol, Crisol or whatever the disinfectant solution, where you are killing the microorganisms, that is on the surface, but where you are not removing any spores. Now, what do you mean by antiseptic? So when you apply some antiseptic on your skin or any wound, it removes the microorganisms from the skin. Such things are called as antiseptic. That means which remove the sepsis of the growth of microorganisms, which inhibits the growth of microorganisms. Next terminology is inanimate objects. What do you mean by inanimate objects? Any item which is not living, whether it is table, chair or whatever it is, which is not living, such things are called as inanimate objects. So when you speak about inanimate objects, you speak about disinfection. When you speak about human or any biological sterilization, that means if you want to sterilize your wound or remove microorganisms, then you call it as, and this is a definition of sterilization. Then the first and foremost thing is, you need to know certain values of factors of sterilization. So the efficacy of sterilization depends upon initial burden of microorganisms on any sample. What does it mean? Suppose my bio burden on sample is very high, the number of cycles at which I do sterilization should be more. If my number of bio burden on my microbial burden on my sample is less, even though if you do a number of cycles less, that is very acceptable. So as per the definitions, we have some certain values called as D value. What do you mean by D value? D value is also called as decimal reduction value. What does it mean? It is the temperature and time required to reduce the microbial count by 90% or by a factor of 10. What does it mean? Suppose there are a total 100 population of microorganisms in 1 million. So once you, after sterilization, it should the D value says that it should be reduced by 10 in 1 million. So that is the fundamental definition of, it should reduce by a factor of 10 or it should reduce by 90%. So what do you mean by Z value? Z value is the number of degrees of temperature change that will change the D value by a factor of 10. So what does it mean? So Z value is also very precisely determine how well your sterilization is done. The next method is F0 concept. What do you mean by F0 concept? Suppose in dry heat sterilization, where we use a hot air oven, where the temperature is fixed, that is around 160 degrees centigrade for 2 hours. It is a fixed protocol of dry heat sterilization. But certain time period is also mentioned for certain sterilization process, that is 2 hours at 160 degrees centigrade. Suppose if you are using another protocol, that is if you are decreasing the temperature or if you are increasing the temperature, that should provide same lethality as the standard protocol. The level of degree of same lethality is identified in the terms of F0 concept. So this is also one of the best definition of how well you the products are sterilized, though you change the optimum conditions of sterilization. So next one is sterility assurance level. What does it mean? How well the products are sterile or non-sterile, based upon the sterility assurance level we can identify. Now what is overkill? Suppose if your product is thermally stable, you can even prolong the number of sterilization cycles as well as temperature. Thereby you can achieve maximum amount of sterilization, that is called as overkill. So this is the fundamental definition. So the acceptable spores in a population is 1 in 10 power 6, that is 10 power minus 6 is the acceptable value. Further, if you want to even get overkill, you can even exceed the value of D to 12D. Suppose if you see in a population, there are about 100 microorganisms. By subjecting a 2D value, that is 2 decimal reduction values, I will change that to from 100 to 10. Now again by doing 6 more cycles, that is up to 80, I will go up to 1 in 10 power 6. And if I go to 12D, this 12D is called as overkill. That means it will completely eliminate the product. But however, the complete removal of microorganisms depends upon thermal stability as well as method of sterilization used for a particular product to be sterilized. So these are the fundamental definitions you need to understand prior to go into any process of sterilization. Next thing is how you will define sterilization. So these are the fundamental graphs shown here. These graphs give you an information. Suppose if you see, this is the dose at which the sample is subjected to sterilization. This generally it is for radiation kind of materials where you supply gamma radiation. So that is in GY, that is my dose, that is mega radians, total number of mega radians the sample is subjected. And survival, so if it is survival, initially it was N, so as the D value shows it to 10 power minus 6, what does it mean? 1 in 10 power 6 population of survival. So that is the best and optimum scale of measuring. Now here if you see number of cells, that is number of viable cells of microorganisms, upon increase in time and temperature, you will get the number of viable cells is being reduced. So this cycle also explains you about microbial death curve. The another one is the total number of population and the time at which it is exposed. This is also gives you the biological death curve. So as more the death curve towards the apsica, the death of the microorganisms is more. This is the fundamental protocol by which we sterilize the products. Now types of sterilization. There are three different types of sterilization. One is physical method of sterilization. The other one is chemical. And the last one is mechanical method, or simply you can say it as filtration. So first and foremost thing you need to know is the container in which you are going to be sterilized, that should be the final one. So further, if you should not transport the product into sterilized product into one, from one container to another container. So if the sterilized container is not the final container, then you should use the microbial filters, that is around 0.22 or 0.45 microns, to filter off the sterilized product into a fresh sterile container. So this is the fundamental definition you need to remember. So in again, if you go for physical method, there are the classification of physical methods is in this fashion. It is sunlight, again one is drying. However, the physical methods of classification are the dry heat sterilization, or moist heat sterilization, and radiation. Sunlight, suppose if you want to dry any of the natural products, that is, if you want to dry any plant products, so it is always advised to dry in shading. What do you mean by shade? Why not in sunlight? Because when you expose the sunlight, the plant material may degrade. So if you are, so the active constant in the plant may be degraded by the sunlight. So this is also utmost care should be taken on what type of material you are using, whether you are using for biological or any process. For any household items where you do not bother about the constituents, then you go for sunlight drying. And simple drying is, suppose whatever you synthesize in your labs, any chemical compounds, you leave it as such for prolonged period, subjected to drying. So this is also simple drying. And further, if the physical methods are categorized into three types, one is dry heat, the other one is moist heat, and radiation type of sterilization. Now in dry heat, again we have a classification of dry heat, that is red hot sterilization, flaming, other one is incineration, and another one is for hot air oven. These are the fundamental classification of dry heat sterilization. In red hot, so whatever the inoculation loop which you use in microbiological labs, where to transfer the microorganisms from the culture to media, where we generally red hot the inoculation loop to make it sterile, that is what dry heat sterilization. Flaming, generally the flaming is done for the test tube, the tip of the test tube is subjected to flame. So this is also one of the method of sterilization of your test tubes. Incineration is a process where the hospital waste is subjected to high temperature, somewhere around 1000 degrees or more than 1000 degrees centigrade, where the complete product is being destroyed. So such type of thing is called as incineration. So hot air oven, so this is the utmost important method of dry heat sterilization, which we are going to discuss in detail. So this is the what dry heat sterilization by hot air oven. In hot air oven, generally the temperature is maintained around 160 degrees centigrade for 2 hours to adequately sterilize the products. In hot air oven, the product should be non-liquid, and they should be thermally stable, and they should be powders. These are the fundamental information which you need to understand before going for dry heat sterilization. This is an oven where there is a passage of open air as well as dry heat is subjected to heat by in the terms of coiled heat or by electrical conversion to heat. This is a instrument which is shown here. So always heat and air is passed that to the sample. So in dry heat sterilization, the microbe organism is subjected to oxidative stress. So how you will know that your dry heat sterilization is perfect and it is able to remove complete microorganisms? So that is the what we use an indicator. The indicator is spores of Bacillus atrophius, that is Bacillus subtilis niger, used for validation and routine monitoring of performance of the dry heat sterilization. So for the typical sterilization process, which is encountered by a temperature of 160 degrees centigrade for 2 hours, the D value should be less than 2.5. Again, what is D value? D value tells you the decimal reduction value. That means there is a reduction of 90% of the micrograms, or a logarithmic of 10 scale reduction of the your by a factor of 10. So this is the what a dry heat sterilization explains you. Here it is the sample is subjected to oxidative stress. So this is the fundamental definition of dry heat sterilization. And coming for moist heat sterilization. So moist heat sterilization, the moist heat sterilization is classified based upon the temperature which the process is used, below 100 degrees centigrade, 800 degrees centigrade, and above 100 degrees centigrade. And below 100 degrees centigrade, we see that is a technique of pasteurization and inspeciation. And 800 degrees centigrade, we see it is boiling and tindalization. and above 100 degree centigrade, it is autoclave steam. So we are going to detailly discuss about autoclave. However, these further techniques which are less than 100 degree centigrade are also very important. This boiling and tenderization also important for routine purpose. And pasteurization, and in pasteurization there are two methods. One is the holder method as well as splash method. This is the for general for milk and milk products. And further, it is inspiration is also useful. You can read them from any standard textbook. So where the D value is reduced by one log cycle or by 1/10 of the specific temperature, here they in the steam sterilization or moist heat sterilization, bacillus stereothermophilus is used for the as a what do you say indicator. Sometimes you can use bacillus subtilis also when the temperature is less than 120. So this is the biological indicator. The most of the biological indicator above 121 degree centigrade, it is 120 and above 120, the moisture, that is bacillus stereothermophilus. This is the fundamental biological indicator. Based upon the D value and decimal reduction value, we will identify. These are the biological indicator to identify the, what do you say, a moist heat sterilization. Further, if you come for autoclave or steam sterilization, here the preconditioning of sterilization instrument is very important. What do you mean by preconditioning? Steam sterilization itself tells you that hot steam is passed on to the vapors of steam is passed on to the sample, where you have to evacuate the chamber by complete evacuation by air. So whatever the air present in the chamber is been removed by either by supplying vacuum or by degassing. So once the complete, this is called as preconditioning. And the mechanical and instrumental validation should also be done. When coming to dry heat sterilization, when there is no sample is placed in the oven, when the oven is running at 120 degree centigrade, the temperature fluctuation should be not more than 1, plus or minus 1. This is what standard 1. In the same time, if the oven is operated at 250 degree centigrade, the fluctuation allowed in the instrument is plus or minus 25 degree centigrade. This is the fundamental standard protocols to be followed for the validation of instruments. Coming to moist heat, so I already told you the preconditioning of complete removal of air or oxygen by supplying vacuum or by inert gases is a fundamental protocol of sterilization in moist heat. And in moist heat, generally the you sterilize the culture media which are liquids or which cannot tolerate the thermal stability by dry heat sterilization. So you generally go for surgical equipments are also sterilized by steam sterilization. So again, here the biological indicator for steam sterilization is Geobacillus stereothermophilus. So here when the temperature is 121 degree centigrade, the biological indicator is Geobacillus stereothermophilus. And if the temperature is less than 120 degree centigrade, you can use Bacillus subtilis as your biological indicator based upon the decimal reduction value. So if you see any biological indicator is given with ATCC7953, this is the accession code from the organism in which it has been isolated, or this is the trade number which manufacturer supplies you, which has some definition of the total validated reported of the microbial counts, etc. Now what is an overkill approach? Overkill approach is applied to those objects which are completely thermally stable, where you can prolong the heating cycles or dry heat or moist heat cycles with prolonged time. So let us see, assuming that resistance to sterilization is equivalent to the biological indicator, that means, see, one thing you need to know, what type of biological indicator you should use. The biological indicator should have more microbial burden than the sample which you are going to analyze. So what does it mean? Suppose if your sample has a limit of microbial burden of 10⁻⁶, your biological indicator should have more microbial count than it. This is the fundamental definition you need to know. Suppose if a microorganism having 10 power 2 microorganisms in its I am giving an 2D what do 2D cycles will reduce it to a value of 1. That means 100 is reduced to 1 by 2D cycle. Further, if I am giving 6D more than 2D, that means total 8D, I am obtaining a value of 10 power minus 6. The 10 power minus 6 is the limit at which it is acceptable by the authorities. Whereas if I am subjected to 12D, that means 12 times the decimal reduction value, this approach is called as overkill approach. So the what type of approach you apply onto the sample depends upon thermal stability of the sample, as well as method which you are sterilizing the sample, as well as the biological burden of the sample. So these are the three fundamental definitions you need to know prior to performing any sterilization. Next one, we come for radiative sterilization. In the radiation, there are two types of radiation. One is ionizing radiation and non-ionizing radiation. What do you mean by ionizing radiation? Ionizing radiation is sometimes called as cold sterilization, and non-ionization radiation is called as hot radiation. Why we are calling an ionizing radiation as a cold? Because there is a minimal change in temperature of the sample subjected to ionizing radiation rather than more change. So again, here we are using a biological indicator to study whether the sterilization is complete or not. The biological indicator used here is Bacillus pumilus. It has been labeled as for the count less than 10 power 7. The D value should be in the range of 0.152 to 2 mega radians. This is radians is the amount of dose which you are giving. So here the ionizing radiation is the best part is you can identify the total amount of dose which you are giving to a sample, and the total amount of dose absorbed by the sample can be easily identified here in radiation sterilization, especially with ionization radiation. Here two types of metals you are using for giving the ionization. One is cobalt 60 and cesium 137. These are radioactive in nature, so which gives gamma radiation. This gamma radiation is very helpful in destructing the microorganisms. So for gamma radiation, effective sterilization dose is 25. So that is 2.5 mega radians. This is the fundamental approach to get overkill approach. Coming to chemical sterilization. Chemical sterilization again is of two types. It is gaseous sterilization and liquid sterilization. In gases, we are subjected to the product is subjected to ethylene oxide, formaldehyde or vapor phase hydrogen peroxide. In the liquid one, we can use alcohol, phenol, cresol. Sometimes you can even use hypochlorite, provided that the product is non-biological. This is the fundamental definition which you are going to read about the sterilization product. So one more thing is, in the gaseous sterilization, you need to know one thing, that the oxidative products of the gases which are subjected for sterilization should be completely removed from the oven periodically, so that these may not contaminate the product, so that the batch recall may not be very big problem for the chemical sterilization. Coming for gaseous sterilization, again here we are using Bacillus atropius as an biological indicator for gaseous sterilization, where ethylene oxide, the D value, for the permissible D values are also given here. The D value should not be less than 2.5 minutes for certain values given by here. That is ethylene oxide exposure. So this is a fundamental protocol for gaseous sterilization, where you either give the complete ethylene oxide or ethylene oxide along with some other diluent gases. So biological indicators, these are already I have discussed at each and every place. So again, I am going to review once again. So the vapor phase hydrogen peroxide sterilization process, here we use Geobacillus thermophilus and Bacillus atropius and Clostridium sometimes. And moist sheet sterilization, we use Geobacillus thermophilus and Bacillus subtilis sometimes at less than 120 degrees centigrade. And ionizing radiation uses Bacillus pumilus. Filtration method, we use Pseudomonas diminutiae. One thing you need to understand while using a filtration method, a filter which has standard colony forming unit CFU, which can retain at least 10 power 7 microbes on its surface, should be used for the filtration of your any products. Further, Brown's tube method. This Brown's tube method is also one of the fundamental method used in preparation of any standard sterile microbial solutions, where your products are subjected to certain standard chemicals. Any color change will able to know so whether your sterilization is up to mark or not. So these are the fundamental definition you need to know prior to performing any survival and kill time. So what do you mean by survival time and kill time? Survival time means, suppose if you procure any standard biological indicator from the vendors, it should have a survival time in minutes which is not less than the D value. What do you mean by D value? Decimal reduction value. That means your D value is depends how well the survival time is. The survival time is less, then it is not a very good biological indicator. So the survival time, always it should be more than the labeled D value of the indicator. Kill time, so that is the time required to kill the microorganisms. This should be more than the D value. What do you mean by D value? D value, reduce the microbial count by either 10 power 2 or 10 power minus 6. So based upon the number of cycles of exposure. So if the kill time is more, what does it is not more than the labeled D value. What does it mean? If the kill time is more than the labeled D value? So this is the fundamental thing which you need to know. If your kill time is less or less than the D value, that means it is within the limits. That means the microbial count is not more than the specification. If the kill time is more, that means if more number of cycles are required to kill the microorganisms, that means your microbial count provided by the vendor is fault on the label. So this is the fundamental information which you need to know. Next one is colony forming units. This is the fundamental information which you need to know. So prior to any performance of sterilization, the total number of microbial count in terms of colony forming units is studied, and after the subjection of sterilization, the colony forming units are studied. The reduction in value of D value prior to sterilization and after the sterilization is the fundamental of characterization of perfect sterilization procedure based upon the utilization of biological indicators also. So this is the fundamental definition which we go encounter while doing any sterilization procedure. So these are the characteristics of sterilization protocol. So this is the characteristic. What do you say? Excuse me. This is the characteristic sterilization protocol. So in this protocol, we generally see the kill time, maximum survival time, minimum D values, and example of typical D values. So if you are doing for dry heat sterilization, again here in dry heat sterilization, what are the biological indicator? Bacillus atropius. So this is the fundamental information. What D value is 1.9. So minimum D value should be 1 and maximum up to 3 within this range. This is the tolerance range at which your D values are accepted. And survival time, minimum 4 minutes and maximum 14 minutes. Beyond this, whatever the biological indicator should not be survived. Kill time, that is minimum 10 and minimum 12. It is a fundamental flow chart which tells you about the perfect. When you use ethylene oxide, that is 600 milligram per liter as your sterilization method, where again you have some certain parameters of D value of 3.5 and tolerance value, minimum survival time and kill time. Now when you use the moist heat sterilization, that is in moist heat sterilization by any of the method of by using sterilization by or by pressure cooker or any other method of sterilization where you sterilize your biological preparations as well as your surgicals. They have a D value of 1.9, and these have also have survival time as well as minimum and maximum tolerable minimum limits and the kill time. This is the fundamental of today's topic of discussion, which completely helps you about the D value, G value, decimal reduction value, kill time, F naught value. So once again, I am telling you, F naught value is the value where you do not take standard procedure or standard, what do you say, standard operation of reporting times or temperature. So the it should be the E, provide same lethality as the standard procedure, that is called F value. Whereas D value tells you decimal reduction value and logarithmic reduction value. G value is the temperature at which the decimal reduction value reduces by 10%. So pasteurization, tinderization, these are all the fundamental definitions of sterilization which I have discussed. So if you like, subscribe, share, and if you want any doubts, please subject to comments, and you can even WhatsApp and email me, which are provided in my opening slide. Thank you once again. Bye. Welcome for the future lecture.